Here, squeeze that thing.
See, that's really what you want when you're breaking it off.
Right. Oh, stay down. Stay down. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Feels like the 1940s. Oh, yeah.
Oh, no! Pressure's on a little bit. Stay down.
Oh, someone get this. Look at that stork.
Oh, what is that? Stay back. Yep. Oh. Step. Yeah. That's reading a ground ball right there. Way to read a ball, fella. Way to read a ball.
Telling yourself?
Yeah. Oh, my gosh. Play the hop. Play the hop. Yes, Jack. Yes.
Oh, wow. Your legs move like something fast.
Favorite part of this game was after Shohei's first home run. Since Shohei was pitching, when he got to the dugout, instead of giving high fives, he gave virtual high fives. Because he wanted to preserve his pitching arm and not get too tired out.
His recorded pitch in college baseball history. And he whizzes one by Altuve. Some more gas. This kid's not even from Texas. But he blows away Jose Altuve.
That look for Jose Altuve at the mound. Wow. That's respect.
1-0 right here. That is high. That is deep. That is wide. That is number 27. And there's the first strikeout of the night. Swing and a miss. There's a strikeout. That's in there. Strike three call. Two, Robert. Swings and misses. Tommy hits one in the air, left center field, hit well, Robert is back, so is Benintendi, it's gone! Shohei Ohtani with his second of the night!
One thing that I wish I knew when I played is that hitting home runs is actually a simple formula. So if you want to hit for more power, here's some things you can do. Yeah, hitting's still hard, but the faster that you can rotate and the faster that your bat goes, the harder you're going to hit the ball. So the first thing I wish I used are med balls. You don't even have to worry about hitting a baseball. You just have to get in your stance, load, and throw it as hard as you possibly can. Remember, the faster you rotate, the harder you'll hit it. The second thing I wish I used are swing trainers like the Pro Velocity Bat. You can use this bat in multiple ways. It has these rubber bands on that you connect, and now it makes it even harder to move the barrel. So first, you just have to swing it as hard as you can, and over time, the harder you swing, the more bands you'll get. If you hear that sound of it hitting the end, then you did it right and you can move on to the next band. Eventually you'll get to a point where it won't go down all the way, and that's okay. It just means that you need to use it more so you can swing harder. What's even cooler about this bat is you can actually hit with it. Go ahead and get set up like any other swing. Just make sure that your barrel is moving at the right time. Definitely go check these guys out. But let me know how you like to train bat speed. Somewhere to start. No need to ask, he's a smooth operator.
He's 12. Well, he's throwing 60% right now. He was invited out to a national tournament with 5-star last weekend through 20 scoreless innings, so his advisor said to just keep it light, you know what I'm saying, at these lower level tournaments.
As you're running off the field, you're 33. You look like you're 23. For the people at home, what's the secret to the success? How do you stay in such great shape?
Hey, marry someone who wants the best for you and brings the best out of you. My wife, she keeps me younger, and so does my son, Messi. Keep getting better with time.
Yeah. You're the man. Thank you, Jason, very much.
Thank you, fellas. Appreciate you.
Appreciate you. That is blitzed to right center field. Off the top of the wall. De La Cruz storms up to second base. First pitch in the air to right. Acuna back. His bat. That's in the center. Base hit. De La Cruz. He is a triple shot.
Three opportunities.
De La Cruz, right center. Down base hit. Could he go three? India around third. India scores.
fluttering in for a strike.
Here's a 3-1 pitch. Wainwright out to deep left field. Do it yourself. He has. 3-run homer, Adam Wainwright. And this game is tied.
I mean, they're a couple rows over, but bro, there's nobody here.
Absolutely not. That's not how it works. You sit where you pay to sit. Now let me see those tickets.
Amigo, those are not your seats. They're my sister's. Oh, mom. How about 50 pesos? Well, you enjoy the game. Salud. Gracias.
And you will always remember where you were June 28th of 2023.
Anyone just sign up for the MLB draft? Before getting signed, I had absolutely no clue how the MLB draft process worked. So here's a little behind the scenes that I wish someone told me. See, whoever gets drafted is first sent an invite via email to the MLB Draft Prospect link. This is a website where all 30 MLB organizations are represented. They can add you to their list of guys they're interested in, and once a team adds you, then you have to fill out their questionnaire. These questionnaires include questions like, do you have any family who played pro ball? Do you even want to play pro ball? You also have to go to the eye doctor and get an official eye exam. Then you have to upload your whole medical history and report any injuries that you've had in the past. Leading up to the draft, you might get invited to several different workouts, and these are basically showcases where teams can see what you got, but they're usually by invite only. Some kids get invited to the prospect link in high school, and others were in college. I didn't get my first MLB prospect link invite until my junior year of college. So when someone asks how you know so much about the MLB draft process, you can tell them Brack taught me.
Two balls were hit at the same speed with the exact same launch angle, but one of them went over 100 feet further. That's because this game was played in Mexico in a stadium 7,349 feet above sea level. That's 2,000 feet higher than Coors Field, with fences significantly shorter, meaning this was one of the easiest games to hit a home run in ever. 10 different players hit a home run in this game. There were 11 in total. Both teams had two back-to-back homers each, and these homers combined for over 4,858 feet in distance, the third most ever recorded. According to Logan Webb, 75% of the Giants, quote, got the shits while traveling to Mexico, making it a terrible trip for them. There was a bobblehead of Juan Soto that looked nothing like him, and the Padres won and smashed a few piñatas. So stand upon pillars of salt.
And now Hunter Pence is going to make a pitching change.
Great moment.
Do we say he just completely forgot how to pitch? This was Alec Manoah last year. Looked like a young phenom, finished third in American League Cy Young voting at a 2.24 ERA. And this season, his ERA ballooned to almost 7 and he was sent down to the Florida Complex League. It's not AAA. Like, this is rookie ball. We have the results from his first start in rookie ball today. It's not good.
Came up firing. Middle of 5. Nope, not going to say the score.
To be honest, I think my biggest dream was probably yesterday, and I didn't even know it. And my next biggest dream is winning a national championship. I can't think of anything else right now. And to do it with the guys that we have on our team in that locker room, it's going to be really rewarding if that does happen. And then past that, it gives me an opportunity to grow every day, to get better. It gives me a purpose, you know, when I wake up in the morning. Last year, we might have had 100 people at our games at Falcon Field, and now we have 25,000 people. We had 10,000 people at Alex Box Stadium every single game this year, just to watch me play a game and watch me compete. And it's been really cool to have an audience for that, and really hope that continues. I'm going to do everything in my power to keep competing and you know, make that happen, but that's what I want to do.
Favorite hat you've worn in your career?
The Astros hat that says World Series on it.
Does feel pretty nice.
I like the Lowell Spinners hat and the Portland Sea Dogs hat. That's, you know, just the Northeast teams I play for.
I like the pink. I like the Mother's Day stuff.
Oh, yeah.
I like wearing all the pink stuff.
Cowboy.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, cowboy.
Que color?
Black.
The Grizzlies in Fresno was pretty cool. Taco days and stuff like that.
Raspas in AA. They're like these lime green, but they had like a slushy on them.
Either High A, the Black Ops jerseys, or the Blue Ghosts from Corpus.
Really like the Corpus, like blue, navy blue with the red.
The Mission.
The Chanclas hat.
Yeah,
the
dude,
Chanclas.
We found that a lot.
The Chanclas hat.
So the San Antonio Mission, the Chanclas hat.
It was like the baby blue Corpus Christi hooks in AA.
Mother's Day one we had this season. I think that was pretty cool.
We did like a Call of Duty night in Fayetteville when I was in High A. And it was really cool. It was like all black.
4 de julio en doble A.
Doble A?
Sí, en doble A.
Yo en triple en Round Rock. The Chupacabras. Chupacabras. Chupacabras.
Fire.
So black with green. But a monster here. It's nice.
They're my big Mother's Day guys.
Yeah.
You know, shout out to my mom. Love my mom. Anytime I wear the hats, the wristbands, the bat, she gets it all. So shout out to mom. It's Mother's Day.
She's got to have a fat stack now.
Hey, she got a lot of.
So much volcano. Come on. No volcano, yeah. No volcano. ASO, too much volcano. Nowhere.
In a suit and tie.
No way. What's going on?